Welcome back to another enthusiastic day at New Salem Elementary School.
This is Myra Spriggs and Ava Dietrich reporting to you from our WNSC studio.
Today is Monday, November 12th, Cycle 10, Day 3. Ms. Green is here for art and Ms. Cole is here for music.
For lunch today, regular choice is fish sticks with macaroni and cheese or a peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Happy birthday wishes go to Braden Light and Azra Music.
Happy birthday!
Temperatures will be in the upper 40s with mostly sunny skies.
Help for Our Heroes is an effort to provide personal care items for veterans in need.
Please consider bringing in socks, toothpaste, soap, deodorant, and shampoo in the next few weeks to help those who served our country.
There is a collection bin in the office for you to drop off your things.
This week begins our Fill the Bus campaign.
Every year we set out to fill an entire school bus with food to donate to the local families through the Harvest of Hope Food Bank.
The pantry currently serves approximately 800 people per month, serving the Spring Grove Area School District and parts of West York.
Last year we collected 8,000 pounds of food for families in need.
Some of the items of need include cereal, boxed potatoes, canned vegetables, canned fruit, pasta, hamburger helper, mac and cheese, peanut butter, soup, spaghetti sauce, canned tuna, and rice.
Thank you for helping us reach our goal.
Wednesday evening is the instrument showcase in the gymnasium beginning at 7 p.m.
Yesterday was Veterans Day.
Let's take a look at how we can honor the men and women of the armed forces.
You probably know that every year on November 11th, Americans celebrate Veterans Day to honor the millions of men and women who have served or are serving in the nation's armed forces. But bet you didn't know the whole story behind the holiday. For starters, it wasn't originally called Veterans Day, but Armistice Day, to commemorate the truce signed between the Allies and Germany in World War I on the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month of 1918. The first Armistice Day in the U.S. was celebrated on November 11th, 1919. All business was suspended for 2 minutes starting at 11 a.m., and parades and public gatherings were held to commemorate the occasion. Later, America also began honoring its unknown soldiers on Armistice Day, a tradition that continues today. At 11 a.m. every Veterans Day, a color guard ceremony represents all branches of the military at the Tomb of the Unknowns in Arlington National Cemetery. In 1954, the name was changed to Veterans Day following a national campaign to have the day honor all veterans, not just those who served in World War I. And did you know, for 7 years, Veterans Day was actually celebrated in October? In 1968, Congress moved Veterans Day to the fourth Monday in October so that government employees could enjoy a long weekend. But in 1975, President Gerald Ford returned Veterans Day to November 11th due to the historical significance, and that's where it sits on the calendar today. And do you know the difference between Memorial Day and Veterans Day? Both of them honor those men and women who have served in the military, but Memorial Day honors America's war dead, while Veterans Day honors all American veterans, living and dead. The U.S. Census Bureau estimates that there are currently over 21 million living military veterans in the United States. More than 16 million of these served during times of war, while 5.5 million served during peacetime only. So this Veterans Day, don't forget to say thanks to some of the millions of men and women who have served our country.
Thank you for watching our broadcast today at New Salem Elementary School, where I'm in the house.
Are you in the house?
Please rise for a moment of silence, followed by the playing of our national anthem and the pledge to the flag.